Becomes a weapon. From head to toes, teeth. Lock and rip in the groin. Take down. Finish it off. Ripping technique, the technique of ripping like an animal. The technique of suffocating. Suffocate. Like the stingray. Technique of the head, elbows, strike to the body. All techniques to kill, to maim, and to kill. Rip cage, back broken. Finish it off technique, all lethal techniques. Ripping, clawing, ripping like a tiger, like a wolf. Blade hand like the eagle swing to the side of the knife. By stepping. Now, it's going to be rehearsed. Take down, roll it out to rip out the organs. Lock it, kick it, using legs. Combination, sweep it, kick it. Lock, take down, rip, finish it off.
Of the bee and the hawk.
Keep going. The technique of the mantis, lion, and the technique of the ramp. Sacrifice technique. Spinning technique like the wind, suffocating technique of the tunnel of oxygen. Flowing technique of the ghost, blending with the opponent. Breaking, dislocating techniques. Yes, the technique of the blade arm. Thank you. Technique of the ninja. Killing technique, striking to the throat. Yes, reverse techniques. Drawing from the blind side. The opponent can't see and can't fight. Multiple techniques, whirling techniques. Back neck breaking techniques, finishing off a rupture in the spleen. Empty hand against the blade. Double blade, double knife attacks. Using big cartoon throws. Disarming techniques against two knives, finishing off. Empty hand against weapons. Blending with the attacker. Utilizing the attacker's momentum to off-balance the attacker. Attacker defeats himself. Double slashes. Yes. Landing with your opponent, kicking him from the reverse side. Thank you! Walking, striking, ripping technique. Sacrifice throws. Finish it off. Walking techniques, kicking techniques, ripping techniques, followed by takedown. Finish it off. Action. Yes, the technique of the acrobat, the technique of the crab, leaping and hooking and clawing. Yes, the technique of the hawk, the eagle, London, fluid technique, striking, ripping, striking, continuous striking. Keep going. One more time.
Robert Crossan from Brooklyn. He's a six-degree black belt. He practices jiu-jitsu, karate, aikido. But his approach, he says, is designed for the street.
That's the tri-sectional staff. At one time, the farmers used it to thrash down the wheat as a farmer's tool. Later on, we'll see more of the Okinawan weapons.
Robert Crossan, a man who likes to put a little bit of showmanship into his display, and the crowd certainly appreciates it. He's a man that uses what he calls streetology. That is, that his practice of the martial arts is designed for use out on the public thoroughfare when you're attacked in that dark alley.
I more or less deal with martial arts in the street sense. I deal with teaching martial arts for self-defense, survival, from everyday life situations. Say you may be in an elevator. A lot of times you can't jump up and do a flying sidekick. Not knocking karate, but you may have to do a basic wrist lock if someone comes in close on your stabs with a knife or comes down at your head with a fake club or even a hammer or whatever. You have to deal with the situation from a close range, so you would change and alter to maybe a Aikido wrist lock or maybe a jiu-jitsu throw or pressure point or what have you.
So it's a combination of approaches designed to deal with reality in his home of New York. Now he works with his students in demonstration.
What you're seeing now is a lot of hand and foot techniques. This is a chokehold. This hold would absolutely kill somebody if you put more pressure onto the Adam's apple. This is a round kick, and then he's coming up there with a spinning foot kick, which would hit him on the side of the head temple, say. Again, another devastating blow.
Those spinning back kicks require a lot of flexibility, too, Aaron.
Has to have balance, power, and technique. Otherwise, it would have never worked. What you're seeing now is a roundhouse kick from the opponent. Robert blocks it, spins with all his power and weight, with a crescent kick, would have hit the person in the temple, would have knocked him cold.
Of course, Robert Crossan is pulling up on all of these attacks. If he would deliver them with full power, the results would be devastating. Robert Sugar Crossan, techniques of attack and techniques with a hand.
Those are rollouts, what you're seeing.
Let me tell you that even in demonstration, the energy that he's using is phenomenal. He has to be in absolutely terrific shape.
He is. He works out every day. In fact, he works out 6 hours each day.
The crowd appreciates it. Now watch. Here is his trademark. A little victory flip. Thank you for the crowd.
Incredible show. You have to be absolutely...
After a while, they take their toll, but I feel good. I'm in shape, and I was prepared for it.
All of this can be applied to use for your self-defense on the street.
Yes, it's what we call streetology and street gymnastics. The vibes especially for the street. I put a little show business today, but in reality, the only show would be when the police come and see the body.
We'll be back. This is the father of American ninjutsu, Ronald Duncan. He is an absolute expert with a variety of weapons used in the martial arts. But now he's picked up a simple walking cane.
To a ninja pole, a cane, a pencil, anything can be a deadly weapon.
Ronald Duncan, an ex-policeman, an ex-marine. And the ninjas, in Japanese history, are assassins, assassins for hire, that would deal in deeds that the honorable samurai would not.
The ninja were not samurai and therefore had no weapons, so they learned to make a deadly weapon from anything. Now Duncan has a whip. His opponents have sickles from Okinawa.
The martial arts has been prominently used in cinematic production lately, both historically and in modern times. And Ronald Duncan has an objection to the way the martial arts are being portrayed. He says it does not fit his view of the martial arts.
I think the misconception stems from the fact that a lot of distortion through some parts of the media have exploited the martial arts and have presented the dark side of it, the destructive side. But martial arts aim towards improving the individual's perfect, complete self.
Reading Japanese history, the samurai were honorable warlords, men of distinction, men of honor, and they could not use certain techniques of assassination, attack through stealth. The ninja, on the other hand, were peasants and had no loyalty to any code of honor. So they were hired and used by the samurai warlords for stealth in the night and for assassination.
Here, Duncan's students demonstrate ninjutsu. The samurai was trained swordsmen and would never fight hand to hand. The ninja used his hands as weapons. The resulting techniques was called ninjutsu.
But this 20th century ninja, how would he handle 12 men facing him, each armed with deadly weapons? The men approach. The ninja with the logical solution, a 357 Magnum. Ninja, Ronald Duncan. You know, Aaron, with the rising crime rate in the United States, it seems that more and more people are developing an interest in the martial arts.
There's a mugging every 48 seconds, a murder every 23 minutes, one rape every 6 minutes, one robbery every 58 seconds. In other words, there is a serious crime every 7 minutes. The public is angry about it, and everyone, especially women, seem to be interested in the martial arts. The number of students at my academy in Manhattan has grown 50% over last year.
And here is Hong Kong's Bill Louie, a seventh degree black belt, over 100 tournament championships. He begins by facing three different opponents. Louis concentrates on style and finesse in his approach. While each of these routines is carefully choreographed, they're intended to show his style and his approach to the martial arts. 30 years old, an expert in karate, seventh degree black belt, in kung fu, an instructor, second degree brown belt in judo, second degree brown belt in jiu-jitsu.
What you're seeing now are one-stepper tanks. They are preparing for actual combat. This is to develop the blocking and countering techniques of the defender, as you can see. They are throwing hand and foot techniques, and Bill Louie is neutralizing their attack.
Louie has appeared in 5 different motion pictures, and he hopes to make a career of being an actor in martial arts films. Now watch as he dances in. Back kick, up with a side kick, then a swinging back kick.
Now he uses judo sticks against the bow staff. These are Okinawan weapons. Again, these are one-step attacks in practice drills.
Lightning speed by Bill Louie. The attacker with a bow staff, Louie with judo sticks. Spins, counters, attacks, and wins. Bill, a Chinese with expertise in all forms of martial arts, karate, kung fu, judo, and jiu-jitsu.
Ribbon like a cat, becoming an animal, becoming a cat. convert and transform it into a cat, into a bird, into eagle, into a donkey. Mule kicking. The technique of the monkey, using the teeth to rip out the throat, take him down. Every part of the body is used as a weapon. Every part of the body is used as a weapon. And these are our basic techniques. Walk, rip, take down. Thank you, gentlemen. And take down. Yes. Sensei Felix Vasquez and Carlos Vasquez. Suffocating the opponent. Suffocation. Thank you. Ah. Of the internal system. The technique of the eagle, leaping, roaring, suffocating, flying, taking out. Techniques designed to rip and claw and break the back of the attacker. Technique, the way of the wind system. Ripping, clawing, ripping and clawing. Thank you very much, gentlemen. All right. Move it. Keep it going. Move it. Keep it going. Keep going.
Thank you. back quickly. Kill like the wind. With the knife, very quickly. Now this is real. This is ninjutsu today. Knife against knife.
Thank you. What's Yeah. Thank you. is a student technician in crisis management and security operation system. He is an instructor in ninjutsu, in which he has been involved since 1969. Study under the world-famous sensei, Ronald, Duncan. Special reaction team in Fort Dix, New Jersey. As you see, training can start as young as these two individuals here, from 3 and up. Thank you.
exhibition in hand techniques with Sensei Ali, Shafiq. Over the head, strike. Break the elbow. Notice the swiftness of movement.
Thank you.
by movement of the feet, prostrating the body in order to make the knife cuts and the slice without being...
Yeah! These are basic techniques. On the basic level, the technique of bone breaking is known in Japanese as koppo techniques of breaking. You've seen ripping, pivoting, techniques of disappearing behind the opponent, known as the ghost techniques. Sidestepping, attacking from the blind side, taking down, controlling, again breaking the bone. The techniques of Camcorders, breaking, and Taijutsu, Taijutsu blending. Techniques of sacrifice, in the air, like the wind. Walk inside, rip, strike, take the opponent out. The throwing techniques of ninjutsu. Thank you very much, gentlemen.
institute the techniques of taijutsu of the wind variety. Flowing with the technique, killing with the knife. You notice the circular movement of the ninja. The Koshinomawari, taijutsu, wajutsu movements, utilizing the body in conjunction with a bladed device to maim, wound, or kill the opponent. It's called tantujutsu, and the bugei forms in the ninja form is called ninjutsu. Leaping techniques. You notice the movements are never stagnant, never stable, never stationary. Continuous movement. Using all the empty-ended techniques. Blocking. Using circular motion. Ripping, taking down. Basic techniques is taught in our system. The Bindai Ryu, one of the 70 families of the Koga Ryu, Koga provinces of Japan. Ryu having its origins in the year 982 of our time. One of the oldest Ryus of Japan. This is the wind variety of our system, of our techniques. Basic techniques of one-on-one. Done slowly, redirecting the opponent. Using the classical ancient form of taking down, striking with the straight arms, from which all sword techniques derive, the straight human arm of ancient times. Blocking, spinning, blocking, controlling, redirecting. Using the techniques of Aiki, one of the oldest forms of all times, taking down, finishing the opponent off. These are basic techniques, stepping and taking down. We're doing it very slowly for the appreciation of the viewing audience. Ripping techniques, strangling techniques. Enveloping the opponent, using the leg, take down, the trap, strangle, take down, control. Maneuvering under a kick, attacking the opponent from the blind side, suffocating the technique, the opponent, with strangling and suffocation techniques. Block, take down, again from the inside. Basic techniques of taijutsu, one of the many empty-handed systems of what is known today as ninjutsu, commonly known as ninjutsu, an art form dead until recently. I'll say recently, we'll go back to about 1961. There are many existing ryus or schools of the arts of ninjutsu in both the Iga and Koga provinces of Japan. Many of the forms are still being practiced, have been practiced since the end of the Second War in obscurity. The art forms now beginning to emerge once again. As we can see, the American public in the Western world is now fully aware that there is such an art form as ninjutsu. A compendium, a totality, a variety of many approaches, espionage, sabotage, assassination, that's on the dark side, and the reverse of the coin is used for curative and healing purposes. This is merely scratching the surface of what ninjutsu should and should not be.
Thank you. Circle one, switch. Yeah, I'm just a-